manifested all living and non-living beings. And he says that in the Bhagavad Gita, Aham sarvasya prabhavaha mattaha sarvam pravartate iti madva bhajante imam buddha bhava samandita. So that every living entity and non-living entity actually emanate from Krishna. So actually, what we are is one very big family of Krishna. One huge family of Krishna. And our original home is called Golok Vrindavan. And that is in the spiritual world. And there are two parts to Golok Vrindavan. The part that is in the manifest world when Krishna performs his pastimes in the material universe, and in the unmanifest world also. So Srila Prabhupada describes that Vrindavan on this planet is actually Krishna Loka from the spiritual world manifested here in the material world. It's a replica. It's a replica. So Rath Yatra is actually about Krishna bringing his family back again together so that everybody can enjoy the most. It's actually Krishna's biggest celebration program. So if you ever get an opportunity to attend a Rath Yatra, take advantage of it. Because it is the time when you get the greatest blessings from Krishna himself. But why does that happen? Why is it that Krishna chooses the Rath Yatra festival to be the festival of the greatest blessings ever? But before I go into that, I'd like to say, first of all, thank you very much everybody who organized this program, because those who organize the program get some special credit from Jagannath. Because he wants this festival to be organized. At one time, the International Society of Krishna Consciousness will see that Rath Yatra will happen every day in the year, 365 days a year. Right now, Rath Yatra is happening only sometimes because the International Society for Krishna Consciousness, or ISKCON, is in its infancy. We haven't celebrated our first birthday yet. It is described that religious institutions, they are studied in 50-year cycles. Our first 50-year cycle is next year, 2016. So that will be our first birthday. Okay, how much do you expect a child to do by their first birthday? Do you expect much from the child? Imagine if the child is going to be becoming a brain surgeon. What do you expect the child to do in terms of brain surgery in the first year? What? Three things, right? We say, eat, poop, and sleep. These three things the child will be able to do. Now, none of them have anything to do with brain surgery. But they have everything to do with brain surgery at the same time. Because that is what a human being does. That's part of what a human being does. So ISKCON as an organization is actually developing. And it is wonderful to see that one of the main things was, as Yamuna Jivan Prabhu was saying today, that please pull the ratha, please pull the ropes of the ratha so that you can pull Jagannath into your heart. Now that's a very important statement, because this festival can only be celebrated from the heart, because that is where Krishna is sitting. And that is where this festival is celebrated from. So, what I noticed is, because I've been to many Rath Yatras, and I myself have organized many Rath Yatras, I can say that today's festival has a lot of heart in it. I noticed that all of you are very happy, some of you are smiling all the way at all times, even though people were trying to direct you to stop, to start, to do this, to do that, nobody minded. Everybody was happy. And that is the most important part of Rath Yatra. Why? Because of this story. Now I'm going to tell you the story of Rath Yatra. So Rath Yatra started during the pastimes of Radha and Krishna when they appeared on this planet 5,000 years ago. Now Radha and Krishna appear once in every day of Brahma. So Brahma has already celebrated more than 18,000 days already. He's already passed 18,000 days. He's going to live for 36,000 days. He celebrated his 50th birthday recently. So he's crossed his half his cycle. So 18,000 times, ostensibly, Krishna has already come to this planet. once in every 1,000 Kali Yugas, once in every 1,000 Dwapara Yugas. And when Dwapara Yuga comes, the Yugas switch, because the first Yuga is Satya Yuga, then comes Dwapara Yuga, then comes Treta Yuga, and then comes Kali Yuga. But when Krishna comes, Dwapara and Treta switch. Treta comes first, and then Dwapara Yuga comes. Now, of course, Brahma in his first 3,000 days could not create. He became very frustrated. So his spiritual master, whose name is Saraswati, he named his wife after the spiritual master, she actually told him to chant. And if you chant, then Krishna will come, and then Krishna will show you how to create. So then Krishna came. So for us, 15,000 times Krishna already came and left with Radharani, and this time was the 15,001st visit. So during this visit, the pastime of Rath Yatra happens every time Krishna comes. But during this visit, how it happened was that Krishna had left Vrindavan, much to the dismay of all of the residents of Vrindavan. The residents of Vrindavan love Krishna so much, they don't want to be separated from Krishna even for one moment. Even a moment's separation from Krishna creates a lot of unhappiness in their lives. Now you may wonder, who are these residents of Vrindavan? Originally, actually, we are all residents of Vrindavan. It is our expansions that have come out because we wanted to experience something, whatever it was, using our minute independence. So it is described that the gopis, the gopas, everybody became very, very unhappy. And in their unhappiness, they almost died. So at one time, after Krishna had left, the gopis decided, and the residents of Vrindavan decided, that they wanted to go to where Krishna was and meet with him there. So they actually went to a place called Kurukshetra. At that time, in Kurukshetra, the residents of Dwarka had assembled with the persons of Kurukshetra. And so Radharani and the gopis went there, and they met with Krishna, and they decided that they should bring Krishna back to Vrindavan, because that is the place where he enjoys the most. Nowhere can they enjoy more than in the forest of Vrindavan. And there's a very nice story about that. I'm going to tell you that story so that you understand why it is that the forest of Vrindavan is the most important place in creation. So at one time, when these gopis had gone and visited with Krishna outside of Vrindavan, at Kurukshetra, the chief queen for the Dwarkavasis is Rukmini Devi. So Rukmini Devi, she had heard about Rasalila. And so she thought to herself, I want to see Rasalila happen. Because the Rasalila is like the most enjoyable event ever. It's the greatest event ever. So I want to see it happen. So she went to Radharani and says to Radharani, my dear Radharani, please can you do the Rasalila so that we Dwarkavasis can get to see what Rasalila is like. And Radharani said, no, sorry, we're not going to be doing Rasalila for you. And so Rukmini knew how to get to Radharani. The easiest way to get to Radharani is through Krishna. So she went to her husband, Krishna, and said to Krishna, my dear Krishna, if you really love me, please allow us to see the Rasalila. So Krishna, he is a henpecked husband. In Dwarka, he's a henpecked husband. He does whatever his wives want him to do. So he said to Radharani, why not? Let's show them the Rasalila. They want to see it. What's the big deal? Let's do the Rasalila. So Radharani said, okay, if you want us to do the Rasalila, for your pleasure, we will do the Rasalila. So they did the Rasalila, and the Dwarkavasis became totally amazed. They've never seen anything so great. And if you know Dwarka, Dwarka is a very, very opulent place. Extremely opulent place. There is nothing missing in Dwarka. Very opulent. Still, they were amazed. Wow, we never seen anything like this. This is like way beyond our imagination. We never even imagined something as great as this. So then, Radharani says to the gopis, see how much they feel that the Rasalila is so amazing, right? But they don't know that this Rasalila, when it is done in Vrindavan, is much greater. That the Rasalila outside of Vrindavan cannot be compared to the Raslila in Vrindavan, because the arrangements in Vrindavan are so beautiful. The trees, like we here, we've got a canopy here made of wood, right? In Vrindavan, the canopy is made of clouds, beautiful clouds. They form formations. Those formations look exactly like a canopy. And the trees will form the walls, and the ground laden with jewels will form the flooring, and it'll look like such a beautiful castle that even the greatest architect in the world cannot build a castle that beautiful, all made of natural items. Natural items. So Radharani knew that for Krishna to enjoy the most, I have to bring her back to Vrindavan. So she suggested to Krishna, why don't you come back to Vrindavan for a little while? After all, you promised when you left for Mathura that I will come back. And you did not come back. So now, please, we're here, you're here, let's go to Vrindavan for a little while. And so Krishna, remembering his pastimes in Vrindavan, his eyes opened up wide and he thought, wow, I'm going to get to enjoy in Vrindavan again. And his eyes became like saucers. So that's why you see Jagannath, he's got eyes like saucers. And he became so stunned, his limbs withdrew into his body. So that is why you see the form of Jagannath as it is there. Of course, there is another explanation as well, but since you all already know about Rath Yatra, I'm not going to go into that explanation. Let me tell you what actually happened, the original of what happened, and how Rath Yatra started, and why you are actually the most fortunate people in creation. I am, you are all, the most fortunate people in creation to be able to be present during Jagannath Rath Yatra, because Lord Jagannath, Lord Baladev, and Lady Subhadra, by the way, is Yoga Maya. She is the one who arranges all of the pastimes in Vrindavan. Even Krishna and Balaram do exactly what Yoga Maya says. Otherwise, Krishna sometimes may remember that he is God. And Yoga Maya doesn't want him to think of himself as God, because when God is present, there is awe and reverence. But Krishna actually wants pure love. So Yoga Maya covers covers Krishna in such a way that he forgets that he is God. He just acts like a pure lover. So that is who Jagannath is thinking of. That Krishna is Jagannath thinking of. And Baladev, also going into the same mood, also became stunned. And his eyes turned into saucers as well. His limbs withdrew into his body too. And Lady Subhadra, who is Yoga Maya, she became stunned. Although she makes the arrangements, she herself became stunned. Wow, we're going to go back to Vrindavan and form pastimes? There's nothing like Vrindavan. There's nothing like the pastimes in Vrindavan. So they all became stunned. So then they were put on a rath. And then the gopis started pulling the rath towards Vrindavan. And Radharani started speaking to Krishna and saying, didn't you miss us? We had such a nice time in Vrindavan. What happened? How did you forget us? What type of a lover are you that you forget your devotees in Vrindavan? So, and Jagannath is saying, but look, look around us. There are trees all around us. And when we were coming, there were so many trees around us, right? So many nice trees that were around us. So Jagannath says, look, the trees around us. The forest of Vrindavan is right here. Why can't you be happy? And Radharani says, no, this may be a forest, but this is not the forest of Vrindavan. The forest of Vrindavan has very special qualities in it that are not present in this place. So she has that discussion with Krishna, and she actually defeats Krishna. Krishna is trying to explain to her, please be happy, and she's explaining why she can't be happy. But she is very happy that actually Krishna is coming back to Vrindavan, and Baladev is coming back to Vrindavan, and Yoga Maya is coming back to Vrindavan. She is happy. In her heart, she is very happy. And so, there is a pastime that happened in which the gopis questioned Krishna. How is it that if you love your devotees, that you can leave your devotees like that? How can you leave your devotees who love him? How can a lover who loves his beloved leave the beloved like that? How can that happen? So Krishna gives his explanation. I've got devotees all over the world. They need me too. So I need to go and spend some time with them. So the gopis say, but that's not a good explanation. You are Krishna. You can do anything. Why do you have to leave us? And so then Krishna gives another reason. And the gopis come back with another reason why that doesn't sound good enough. Then he comes up with another reason. So like that, there's a discussion happening back and forth. And finally, Krishna puts his hands up like this. And he says, I surrender. You win, I lose. You gopis are so smart. There is no way I can defeat you. You have defeated me. So the gopis said, okay, we have defeated you, but you still have not given us the great happiness of association. So what's the use of being defeated, of defeating somebody, if you win nothing out of it? There's no value in that defeat, right? There's no value. So Krishna says, no, but I will repay you. For the meantime, he says, please accept service as my repayment for your service. The gopis say, okay, that doesn't sound very great, you know? Imagine you had a job and it was the best paying job in the world, right? And say it was you work for, well, let's just for example sake, let's say you work for Facebook, and Facebook offered you the best job in the world, okay? And at the end of the month, you were supposed to get paid, say, $5 million for your work, right? And then you went to the pay clerk, and the pay clerk said, you did such great service that we're going to reward you for doing that service by giving you more service, not $5 million. How would you feel? I mean, I think you'd feel very short-changed, right? You went to pick up your $5 million, and instead you got more work given to you. So the gopis are thinking, doesn't sound really very, very great. Although we love to serve you, Krishna. There's no doubt about it. The gopis and the gopas, everybody in Vrindavan, love to serve Krishna. They serve Krishna so much that they even forget themselves. They forget themselves. But still they were thinking in their mind, this doesn't sound perfect. There's some imperfection here. So Krishna says, no, by and by, wait your time. You will see that I will repay you. And the gopis thought, okay, hopefully this is not going to be a rubber check, you know, that's going to bounce on us. But okay, we trust you. Let's see what happens. And so at one time, Krishna was performing his pastimes, and he got so deep into his pastimes that he went into the mood of Radharani, and then his body became a golden complexion. So everybody yelled out loudly, Go Ranga!
Go Ranga!
Go Ranga!
Go Ranga!
Go Ranga!
Go Ranga!
The whole forest of Vrindavan was chanting, Go Ranga! Go Ranga! Like that. And so everybody was completely stunned. Krishna had become golden complexion in color. Normally he's bluish black. And he's become golden complexion. So, at that time, Krishna, who is none other than Lord Chaitanya himself, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, determined that at the time of Rath Yatra, I will repay my devotees. Because my devotees do so much service. How many of you have done service for Krishna? Put your hands up. Because those who do it are too shy to admit that you do service for Krishna. But all of you have done service. Just by coming to this Rath Yatra, you have done service to Jagannath, Baladev and Subhadra. It's actually the best of all services. Why? You'll understand in a minute as I explain this, that this is the best of all services that you could perform. So, Krishna wants to repay his devotees. He wants to. He wants to pay his devotees for all the wonderful service that they're doing. But he also wants to give them the best repayment. He just doesn't want to give them, you know, something that's cheap. He wants to give them something that is totally valuable. And what is the most valuable thing in creation? What is the most valuable thing in creation? Know the answer. Don't be shy. What is the most valuable thing? Krishna himself, right? There is nobody more valuable than Krishna. Krishna is the cause of all causes. It's like, you know, we're going after a few gold coins, but imagine someone gives you the whole gold mine where there are billions and billions of gold coins. Krishna is the origin of everything, Sarva Karana Karanam. So he wants to give himself to his devotees. so that the devotees can always enjoy it, never be separated from Him, and be happy all the time. That is the boon of Rath Yatra. That is the boon you get today. If you desire, Prabhupada said, if you desire Jagannath, if you desire Krishna at His best, which is Jagannath Himself, and Radharani takes the form of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, and the Rath Yatra happens in Puri, where Lord Gauranga actually dances in front of Jagannath Baldev Subhadra, and a wonderful, wonderful festival happens, and everybody's beaming with joy. Everybody's completely happy. So when Krishna is at his best, he is Jagannath and he is also Gauranga. Gauranga has the mood of Radharani. So here the best of Krishnas relating with one another as Krishna and Radharani in Rath Yatra. And Krishna gives himself, and as I said, Srila Prabhupada said, if you want Krishna, all you have to do is ask. Oh Krishna, I am yours, please become mine. I am yours, please become mine. Prabhupada actually said that whenever you go in front of the deity of Krishna, whenever you go in front of the deities, you should say, oh my dear Lord, I am yours and you are mine. From that point, Krishna becomes yours. And there is nothing greater than anybody can ask for. We ask for small things, we ask for a little bit of money. But none of us can become devotees unless we've already tasted life in Swarga as demigods and demigoddesses. These demigods and demigoddesses have so much money, so much wealth, that this planet is nothing. Each demigod owns many more than one earth planet in wealth. And how much does the wealthiest person in this world own? He doesn't even own a few streets of this planet, right? Forget the whole planet. So, Hiranyakashipu became owner of all the three worlds. And still, he's described in scripture as a beggar. There's a very nice Hindi song, Data Ek Ram, Bikhari Sari Dunya. That the only person who is truly wealthy is actually Krishna himself. One of Krishna's name is Ram. There are five Ramas. Parshuram, Ramachandra, Balaram, Krishna, and the continental Rama is Radharani herself. So Krishna is also known as Ram. So Data Ek Ram, Bikhari Sari Dunya, the whole world are beggars, including Hiranyakashipu, who own the three worlds. So today you are very fortunate, we're all very fortunate that we're here. The only thing you want to do in your heart is to make this prayer, sincere prayer in your heart, oh Krishna, please become mine. Please never allow me to be separated from you, so that I can always be happy in my service to you and my service to your associates like Radharani and Balaram and so many others who are there in the forest of Vrindavan. And the other thing is, Krishna will come, but there is one condition. Krishna's condition is that you must be happy. You must be happy to have Him. If you're not happy to have Him, He doesn't want to come. Because he is the one who manifested us. We are like His children. Am Bija Pradapataha, Krishna says. I am the seed-giving father of all living entities. So He wants His children to be happy. Not just happy. Like how many of you are parents here? Put your hands up. Parents, don't you want your children to be the happiest?
Yes.
Yes. You want your children to be the happiest. You may not so much want the other children to be the happiest, but your children should be the happiest. Well, we are all Krishna's children. So Krishna wants us to be the happiest. But we have to say, I will be happy to have you, Krishna. And when you have Krishna, you will see magical things happen. The movement, the Hare Krishna movement, is doing magical things. It is bringing the whole world together and uniting the whole world together. There is nobody in the Hare Krishna in the world that is not in the Hare Krishna movement. There is no country on this planet where there is no devotee. There are devotees now in every country in this planet. And we have just arrived at our first birthday. And all within the first birthday we've achieved that. Okay? We've achieved so much in our first birthday that all the movements of the world in their first 50 years did not achieve what Hare Krishna has achieved in his first 50 years. And I'm not saying that because I'm a temple president, which I'm resigning from, by the way. And I'm not saying that because I'm a GDC, which I'm also resigning from, by the way. because I want to convince people. It's not because I'm a temple president or I'm a GDC that I'm saying this. I'm saying this because this happens to be the very truth. This is the truth. And please, take advantage of this. Take advantage of this. Prabhupada started this movement at a very old age. How many of you are 70 years or older? Put your hands up. 70 years or older. Okay, I see a baby putting her hand up too. Of course, if you count your previous lives, we're all over 70. But you know, to start something at the age of 70 is not easy. I'm in my 60s and I'm finding it difficult to do things in my 60s. And some of you may be in your 50s and wondering, how can you do these things? How is this all possible? Prabhupada started at the age of 70 this movement. This movement in less than 50 years has become the most powerful movement on the planet when it comes to devotion. Hare Krishna is about devotion. It's not about making money, building big temples, and showing people how great we are. We're about devotion. And we're about individual devotion. Krishna loves each and every one of us completely, individually. He's not a groupie. Krishna is not a groupie. He's an individualist. He considers each and every one of us to be the most important person in creation. That's Jagannath. When Krishna thinks like that, that's Jagannath. And did we notice one thing today? That when the Rath Yatra was going on, so many people were holding up Jagannath. There were many Jagannaths around, right? Do you know why there were many Jagannaths around? Maybe because, of course, some people made some Jagannaths. So there are many Jagannaths around. But Jagannath is trying to tell us that there is one Jagannath for each and every one of us. Krishna loves us individually. There is one Krishna for each and every one of us in the forest of Vrindavan. We need to go back home, back to Godhead. That is the festival of Rath Yatra. Rath Yatra is so that we will understand this and we'll take this to our heart and know that nothing can stop us. Because that was the first instruction that Srila Prabhupada got from his spiritual master. Because his spiritual master wanted to spread Krishna consciousness all over the world. And Prabhupada's objection was, but the British have taken over India. So India is not independent. So the British won't let us spread Krishna consciousness in India. So we should liberate India first. After we've liberated India, then India will become fully Krishna conscious. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said to him, no, that is not correct. Nothing can stop Krishna consciousness. Don't wait for India to become independent. Now we've seen India has become independent, right? Has it become fully Krishna conscious? Heck no. I think a lot of Indians will agree that there's more Krishna consciousness in their lives in America than they were in India. Okay? I've spoken to a lot of Indians, being an Indian myself, I've spoken to a lot of Indians and they say, when we were in India, we were not practicing Krishna consciousness. And we came to America and we started practicing Krishna consciousness. So, Krishna consciousness is available everywhere. It's available everywhere. Take advantage of this program. And most importantly, please pick up some books of Srila Prabhupada. Read those books and help us proliferate these books. So that Prabhupada said, the planet should rain books. Just like when it rains, right? Today it rained. Do you know what rain is before a program like this? It's actually the demigods showering flowers. That's what it is. The demigods, when they shower flowers in Kali Yuga, it comes in the form of rain at a time of an important Krishna festival. And today it rained before the festival. That's the demigod saying, we're very happy you're doing this program, St. Louis. Thank you very much for doing this program for Jagannath. We're blessing you all, and here are some flowers in our appreciation. And so the rain came. So again, I can say, today we are the most fortunate people on the planet. Be happy that you're very fortunate. Pray to Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. Just be happy, but please give Jagannath Baladev Subhadra to others as well. I don't know if I've crossed my half an hour mark. I probably have. I'm a big talker and a loud talker. So thank you very much. Hare Krishna. Jai Sri 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 Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Maharani Ki. Srila Prabhupada ki, Sri Gaura Bhaktavinda ki, Jai, the organizers of Jagannath Rath Yatra ki, the participants of Sri Jagannath Rath Yatra ki, Nitai Gaura Premanande. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.